We are back in Utah today at Utah State University at the Utah Water Research Lab, doing our last and final site visit of the physical model for Isabella Dam. We're looking at our final configuration and what eventually will become the design for Isabella. The only thing we haven't changed in the physical model from the initial configuration is the labyrinth spillway and the upstream topography. We've modified a lot on this physical model, which has been a very useful design tool to help us make a better product. A project this size, really we had to reach out to get expertise from other areas, specifically Utah State and their expertise with physical modeling and their knowledge of labyrinth weirs. And then we sought out to bring in the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers Portland District and their expertise with computational fluid dynamics modeling, which is our full 3D model.
You fly through it much like you do a game, but in this case we're flying through the water. And we're looking at what the velocities are. We're going to use that information and correlate it and match with the physical model to give us confidence in both tools.
So we use all three models together to ultimately come up with the best solution that we can, verifying that it would pass the probable maximum flood, which is the largest flood that we foresee that would ever hit the watershed of Isabella.
It's just amazing to see the water move down these spillway chutes, especially the labyrinth weir. It is so benign and graceful, and then you hear the water that you're passing, and it's just a lot of volume of water moving very quick.
The design that we've come up with today, I think, is the best design. We are increasing the safety of the dam, which ultimately increases the safety of the people downstream.